Warning. The following show may decrease your intelligence. Changing the channel is advised.
Zero variety. Less music. More talking. Weird noises. The show your parents warned you about. This is the Blair Radio Project.
Hello and welcome. Hello and welcome.
Oh, shut up. Stop laughing. It's not funny.
Okay. I know. Hello. And welcome. Hello and welcome.
This isn't funny.
You're right. It isn't funny. It's hilarious.
No, it's not.
Okay. Calm down, Blair. Compose yourself. Hello and welcome to the Blair Radio Project. I'm your host, Blair, and I'm joined by none other than my trusty sound engineer, Billy. Billy, how are you doing today?
You know exactly how I'm doing.
Oh, I know. But the audience doesn't. Go on, Billy. Tell them how you are.
I'm homeless. Shut up.
Tell us why. I love this part.
Last week, when I tried to get rid of that stupid talking computer system...
I heard that.
The system Trigonometry Dean.
Your STD.
Yeah, my STD. When I tried to get rid of it, I couldn't.
You weren't able to get rid of your STD?
No, it wouldn't let me. I tried to cancel the daily 29-pound payments, but instead, it permanently subscribed me to the charges. So, I kept trying, again and again. Then I tried canceling it a few more times, and nothing.
Then what happened, Billy? This is my favorite part.
I thought the other part was your favorite part.
Oh, it's just all so good. It's hard to pick just one. Now, please, continue.
Well, turns out...
Yeah?
Each time I tried to cancel it, when it told me I was instead subscribing permanently, each attempt that I did added another System Trigonometry Dean account that was charged to my mom's credit card. So, instead of only having one account where I got charged £29 a day, we now have 82 accounts that charge us a total of £2,378 per day. Needless to say, my mom can't afford that.
She can't?
No.
What is she? Poor?
She is now. She's lost close to £12,000 in the last week. And even though she ran out of money in her bank, she's still getting charged each day, as well as overdraft fees on top of it.
Hmm. Yeah?
And the rent was due today, but we didn't have any money to pay for it.
Mm-hmm.
So the landlord kicked us out.
Keep going.
And now we're homeless.
Yeah. Amazing. Can you tell it again, Billy?
Shut up.
Audience, today's a bit of a special one. Not only is Billy now homeless, but also today's playlist is completely random. That's right. I put my personal music library on shuffle. So we're just going to see what plays. I have no idea what we're going to be playing today. So starting us off, this is Poppy with the track Her. And you're listening to
Blair Radio Project.
What's that?
What's what?
That thing over there on the wall.
A clock?
Oh, gee, is that what that is?
Yeah. Surprised you didn't know. That's always been there.
No, not the clock, you idiot. The little black thing next to it.
Oh, that?
Yes, that. Why do you have a laser pointer?
It's fun shining into people's eyes while they drive by.
I see.
They can't. Oh, that's a moth.
It's a moth?
Yeah.
Why is there a moth in the studio?
I don't know. Why don't you ask it?
Because it's a moth, Billy. He won't understand me. And even if he does, I very much doubt I'll understand him. Duh.
Right. It's not Jeff the wallet moth, is it? The moth that lives in your wallet?
Nah, I don't have him anymore.
Aw, why?
I lost my wallet.
Maybe he stole it.
Maybe. So, Billy, how did your trigonometry homework go?
You mean my trigonometry homework?
Yeah, that.
I didn't finish it. I couldn't, so I failed the class.
Things are going well for you, huh?
They aren't.
So wait, didn't your mom say that she was gonna make you quit doing the show if you failed that class?
Yep.
So why are you here?
I came in to get my things.
Your things?
Yeah.
You don't have any things.
Sure I do.
No, you don't. You don't even have your own chair.
Yeah, because you never gave me one. But that's not true. I do have things here. Look, see, like this cup. This cup's mine.
No, it's not. That's Craig's cup.
Hmm? Why didn't you tell me I was drinking out of Craig's cup?
I thought you knew.
Why would I drink out of Craig's cup on purpose?
I don't know. You're weird. I don't want to get involved.
All right, fine.
Are you looking around the studio for things that are yours?
Yes! What about under the desk?
Why would something of yours be under the desk?
That's where things go when you lose them. They roll under the desk.
Are you really going to look under the desk? And he's looking under the desk. Mm-hmm. Yep. Do you, see anything?
No. Just some moths. Oh, hey, a wallet!
It's mine! Give it here!
All right, let me get out for-
No, now!
You made me hit my head on the desk.
Jeff? Jeff, are you okay? Jeff? Jeff?
Jeff.
Oh my. Ladies and ladies, I regret to inform all of you. Our good friend, a longtime listener of the show, Jeff the Wallet Moth.
He listens to the show?
Has passed away.
I'm so sorry, Blair.
Me too. Me too. He was so young. He had his whole life ahead of him.
He was too pure for this world.
See this hole in my shirt?
Yeah.
He made that.
What a guy.
I know, I know. He'll be missed. In his honor, I would now like to play 10 minutes of Gregorian chants in his name. We love you, Jeff. We miss you. We miss you. So much. I promise from this day forth, I will always do my best to honor you in any way that I can. You will be avenged, Jeff. You will be avenged.
Can we play music now that isn't Gregorian chants?
Okay, fine.
Thank God that's done.
It's time to lose your faith in humanity. It's the Blair Radio Project. Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt our program.
I can't believe not a single thing in here is mine. I've been working here for over a year. You'd think something in here would belong to me.
Jeff, the Wallet Moth is dead. And all you can think about is material goods.
Life goes on, Blair. We didn't die. Now, there must be something in here that belongs to me. All right. Ah, I know. That there. That pen. It's mine.
The broken one?
Yes, that's mine.
It's out of ink. It doesn't even work. It doesn't even click.
I want it back.
Whatever, sure, here.
Thank you.
Is that it?
Yes, I think.
Okay, so are you gonna go now?
Not just yet. I want to do another check around the studio.
Oh,
Lower your standards. It's the Blair Radio Project.
All that I wanted was you. What are the candles for? And are you wearing a veil?
Can't you see I'm in mourning? This is all for Jeff, the wallet moth.
I see.
So, how long are you staying? How long will you be blessing us with your presence?
I didn't get you any presents.
That's not what I... How much longer are you going to be here?
At least until the end of the show, I guess. I'm grounded now, so I want to make this final visit last as long as possible.
You're grounded?
Yeah.
Okay, but you're homeless. How are you grounded? Usually when you get grounded, you're not allowed to leave the house. What are you grounded from if you're homeless?
I'm not allowed to go indoors.
Your mother never did make any sense.
You talk about her like she's dead.
She's dead to me. Why don't you guys just move in with her rich and amazing boyfriend, Richard?
They broke up.
Oh? Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's too bad. What happened?
My mom got an email from another woman claiming that Richard was being unfaithful to her.
That Richard was being unfaithful to the other woman?
No, to my mom.
Ah.
You said it isn't true, but my mom's not buying it.
Oh. That's a shame. A great shame. Shame indeed. Well, like I said before, Billy, I always thought something was off with him.
You never even met him.
I know, but based on everything I've heard from you about him, you always seem like a liar and a jerk. It's a good thing that Barbara messaged your mother. So tell her. She really dodged a bullet there. Now she can go back to dating a decent man. Perhaps a man on the radio. Oh, does she still have the same number?
Yeah, it's the same.
Okay, I might give her a call, you know, just to see how she's doing, of course.
I doubt she'll answer it.
What was that?
Oh, nothing. I just had something in my eye.
Oh, okay.
Wait, how did you know the other woman was named Barbara?
Well, you said it.
No, I didn't.
You sure?
Pretty sure, yeah.
Well, you must have said it, or else I wouldn't have known it.
No, I'm pretty sure I didn't say it.
Hmm. Well. See, I never... It was just a hunch.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
That was a good hunch.
Very good hunch.
Spot on hunch.
Yeah. Thank you.
Blair, there's like 3 moths by the clock now.
Like 3 or 3?
There's 3 moths by the clock now.
So?
So where are they all coming from?
I don't know, Billy. Why didn't you ask them?
Maybe they're also mourning Jeff's loss.
Don't be stupid. Jeff the Wallet Moth was a recluse, an introvert, a hermit. Other moths didn't know him. They weren't as fortunate as me.
Right. Hey, Thomas from Daft Punk. Now that I'm homeless, can I stay with you?
No.
Hey, you didn't even think about it.
I don't have to think about it. The answer is no.
Oh, come on. I don't take up too much space. You could put me in a burlap sack, put me under the kitchen sink. I won't make a peep.
No.
Please, just think about it first before saying no. It's only for a little bit. Thomas? Please?
I've thought about it.
Yeah?
And it's a no.
Fine. I don't want to live with you anyway.
The feeling is mutual.
Hey, Billy. If your mom needs a place to stay, you know, she could come over to my place.
Really?
Yeah.
Is there even enough room for both of us to come over? Your flat is pretty small.
There isn't enough room for both of you. No. That's why I said she could come over. I never said anything about you.
What? Where am I supposed to go?
I don't know. That's not my problem. Look, you're 9 years old. You're old enough to make your own living arrangements. Figure it out.
Wait, aren't you dating someone? Won't your girlfriend be mad about my mom, who's also your ex, coming over to live with you?
No, because we're no longer together.
Did she break up with you because she found out you lied about being blind?
No.
Did she break up with you because you spend all your money on Game Boy games and never take her out?
No.
Did she break up with you because she found out you were a horrible person?
No.
Then what happened?
She died.
What?
I said she died. clean out your ears.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry, Blair. I had no idea. What happened?
She died.
I know she died, but I mean how?
She cooked herself to death.
What? Like in a pan?
No, she was taking a hot bath, but the bath was too hot, and she cooked herself.
I see. When was this?
About 2 weeks ago, maybe more.
You're not sure?
I didn't exactly put it down in my calendar, Billy, no.
I know, but, you know, most people know the date that a loved one has...
What does it matter? You gonna go back and save her?
No.
Okay, then.
Why didn't you say anything?
I don't know. I didn't know how to bring it up.
You would just say that your girlfriend died.
Yeah, I know, but I didn't want to bring attention away from me.
You mean you didn't want to bring attention to yourself?
No, I didn't want to bring attention away from me. This is my show. It's about me, not her. If I talk about her dying, then she gets all the attention, and not me.
But she was your girlfriend. You've shown more sadness for Jeff the Wallet Moth's death than you did your own girlfriend.
Now ex-girlfriend. Look, if she wanted to talk about how she cooked herself, she could say it on her own radio show.
She didn't have a radio show.
Then that's her problem, isn't it?
You're a sad little man, Blair.
Your mom used to say that to me a lot. So yeah, there's space for your mom to come over if she likes.
She hates you.
So? Can you put in a good word for me?
Sure.
Cool.
You're listening to The Blair Radio Project. And now, with a wide... The Blair Radio Project.
Hello, and welcome to the second hour of The Blair Radio Project. I'm your host, Blair, and I'm joined by none other than my trusty, homeless sound engineer, Billy. Billy, how are you doing today?
Miserable.
Great. Today on the show, we have taken my personal music playlist, well, my personal music library, and made a completely random playlist out of it. So we have no idea what song is coming up next. We don't know what's coming up after that, or the song after that, or the one after that, or the one after...
I get the idea.
Okay, great. So starting us off on the second hour, this is Everybody Wants to Rule the World by Tears for Fears. And you're listening to...
Blair Radio Project. It's that time again. It's the loop of the day.
It's that time again.
It's the loop of the day.
That's right, Billy. It's the loop of the day. Each week here on the show, we play a loop of a sample of a loop. And you gotta guess what song we are looping. So, this week is no exception. So, here is this week's loop. Do you know what? This song was also picked at random. Picked at random by the random... Randomnator. If you know the answer to this week's loop, please give us a call. The number to call, if you're calling from the UK, to call is 555-237. If you're calling from outside the UK, the number to call is to call 555-237. Not that it matters, because no one ever actually calls.
I don't think anyone actually listens to this.
Probably not. This next song, this is Cowboy Blues by Kesha.
I wish I was a cowboy.
I wish I was blue.
It's that time again. It's the loop of the day.
Earlier on, we played this loop. If you, yes you, the one in the hat, the ugly one, please get rid of that hat. If you know the answer to this week's loop, please give us a call. The number to call is call at 555-237. Although that's only if you're calling from the UK. If you're calling from outside the UK, the number to call is 555-237. Well, now's a very important part of the show. This is The Paris Hilton Project. Billy, I think we have a jingle for that, don't we?
Indeed we do.
Please play it, Maestro.
Maestro?
Just play it.
This is the Paris Hilton Project.
Okay, so I know all the other songs on the show so far have been completely random, which is true, I promise you, on my mother's grave.
Your mother's not dead.
I know, but she'll have a grave eventually, won't she?
I guess.
So, they've all been completely random, but with an exception of these two songs. Of course, we have to play Paris Hilton Song of the Day, and then later on we'll be doing the Lindsay Lohan Song of the Day. So, can you believe it or not, we still have more Paris Hilton music to go through. Each time I look, I always find a new single that I've never seen before. I don't think this is ever going to end. This week, on the Paris Hilton Project, we are playing the track Come Alive by Paris Hilton.
Obviously.
Released in 2014. So, here it is.
Attempt to talk to Lindsay Lohan. This is the Blair Radio Project.
It's that time again.
The loop of the day?
No, the Lindsay Lohan song of the day.
Oh, right.
Yeah, that. Each week here on the show, we play a Lindsay Lohan song from her vast discography of two albums, both of which absolute masterpieces, except for the fact that there's a lot of filler in both of them, much like this show. But today's track is not filler. Today on the show, we will be playing the track I Want You to Want Me. It's an original by Lindsay Lohan. And if you've ever heard any other version of this song, it's always been a cover. So here's that song now.
You're listening to The Lindsay Lohan Project. It's that time again. It's the loop of the day.
Earlier on, we played this loop. So Koopa. Who's Koopa? I don't know.
Oh, I know Koopa.
You do?
Yeah, he's the tall fella.
Fellow,
whatever. He's a tall guy who's always going into the broom closet to sniff all the cleaning products during his lunch breaks.
I see.
Yeah.
That's nice. If you know the answer to this week's loop, the number to call is 555-237. But that's only if you're calling from inside the UK. If you're calling from outside the UK, the number to call is 555-237. We will be revealing the answer to this week's loop right after this next song. What is this next song, you ask?
I didn't ask that.
I meant our listeners. One of them might have asked.
I didn't hear them.
How would you have heard them, Billy?
Good point.
This next song is Seal It With a Kiss by Britney Spears, making it the third Britney Spears song we've played on the show today. Well done, Britney.
She didn't do anything.
Good point. All right, I retract my congratulatory statement.
The claps, too?
And the claps.
Good.
There. Like it never happened.
It's time to lose your faith in humanity. It's the Blair Radio Project. It's that time again. It's the loop of the day.
Earlier on, we played this loop. And now for the big reveal to this week's loop. That's right! The answer to this week's loop was none other than Goodbye Yellow Brick Road by Elton John. Wow. Did you get it right? I don't know if you did, because nobody bothered to call in. Oh, hey, hello, welcome back to the Blair Radio Project. What's up with all these moths?
I know, right? They're everywhere now.
It's like an orgy of moths in here.
What's an orgy?
Oh, well, remember last Christmas when your Uncle Chip came over and... ask your mother.
Okay.
Actually, don't. Wait. No. Ask her.
Okay.
What's that noise?
That's the phone.
The phone?
Yeah.
But we never get calls in.
Maybe it's someone calling with the answer for the loop of the day.
But we already revealed the answer to this week's loop.
Do you not want me to answer it then?
All right.
All right, to what?
You can answer it.
Okay.
Hello, caller. What do you want?
I know what you did, Blair. I know you sent me that email pretending to be a woman named Barbara.
Mom?
I didn't figure it out right away, but from listening to today's show...
You listened to the show?
I worked it out pretty quickly.
It wasn't me, really.
You liar! Well, I'll have you know, I just called Richard. We're getting back together. Oh, and next time you try to send someone a fake email, make sure you don't send it from a work email. Barbara@theblairradioproject.com. What kind of idiot do you think I am?
Okay, fine, it was me. But I only did it because I still love...
Don't. Just don't. Save yourself the embarrassment.
Too late.
Don't even say it.
But Billy's mom, please. We're meant to be together.
Billy's mom? I have a name, you know.
I know.
Then what is it?
It's, Billy, can you help me out here?
I don't know it.
This is ridiculous. I'm leaving, Blair. Goodbye.
Oh, come on, Pookie.
Don't Pookie me. Don't call me ever again.
But you called me.
If I ever see you again, I'll rip out your tongue and hang you with it.
So does this mean we'll be moving in with Richard?
I will be.
Great.
But not you.
What?
You got me into this financial situation, so you need to learn a lesson. You can stay there at the station with your little moth friends. You got that?
Okay. Mom?
What?
What's an orgy? I think she hung up.
I think so too.
Well then.
Yeah. So, will you still put in a good word for me to your mom?
Sure.
Cool.
Have you missed an episode of the Blair Radio Project? Listen to highlights of every stupid episode on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. The Blair Radio Project. You'll be glad you did.
Hello, and welcome back to Moth Radio. Radio for moths, by moths. Billy, it was nice hearing from your mom again. I've missed that angelic voice of hers.
It is beautiful, isn't it?
Indeed. Well, audience, thank you all so much for listening to the show this week. I hope you'll join me next week here on the Blair Radio Project. And closing us off this week, this is In Motion by Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross. Thank you all so much. And until next week, bye for now. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. So, where can I sleep?
You can sleep in the corner where I throw my used plasters.
Oh, cool!